Good morning. Let's start our lecture. First of all, I try to recall and maybe explain some basic notions on the basic notions of the previous lecture. I recall that first initial initial construction of our reasoning is a vector space. We fixed some vector space, our basic field here. And suppose we have two different vector space V and U. We can consider the space of linear mapping from V into U, our field A. And this set itself is a vector space. But if you consider this vector space in relations with initial vector space V and U, we have some non-trivial structures on this vector space. And on previous lecture, we consider some partial case when U coincide with basic field K. And in this case, we obtain the so-called space, vector space of linear transformations from V into basic field K, our K. And this set have a natural structure of the vector space. And we denote this vector space by V star. And this vector space is called dual vector space. Dual vector space. What does mean the linear transformations? What does mean linear transformation from V into K? F is some element of V star if F satisfied the following two conditions. First of them, linearity, property of linearity. If we have two vectors v1 and v2, and if we consider the sum of these vectors and apply the linear transformation to this sum, we obtain the sum of its images. And second property, if we multiply arbitrary vector v onto scalar lambda, we obtain the product of the scalar lambda and image of initial vector v. And these two properties define the linear transformation from V into K and linear transformation in general case. And easy to see that as we show before, the sum of linear transformation is a linear transformation and product of linear transformation of some scalar lambda is also linear transformation. We obtain the vector space of linear transformation. And the natural question about the dimension of this vector space. As we saw before, in general case, the dimension of space of all linear transformation from vector space V into vector space U, our field key. If V and U are finite dimensional vector space, then the space of all linear transformation from V into U also finite dimensional, and the dimension of this vector space is equal product of dimensions V and dimension U. In this case, we obtain that dimension, the dual space V star is equal dimension V, exactly as the product dimension V and dimension K over K, but last dimension is equal 1. And in this case, we obtain that dimensions of the vector space and its dual are coincide. We can consider the metric of this linear transformation. We can consider any element P of the dual space V as a linear transformation from V into K, and we can consider the matrix of this linear transformation. If we pick some basis E in the vector space V, let E some basis, we can consider the matrix and let's consider the sum element F of the dual space V star. And we can consider the matrix of this linear transformation from V into vector space K. In the basic field K, if you consider this basic field as a vector space over itself, in this vector space we have natural basis. The unit element of basic field K form such basis. And if we apply linear transformation F into basic element E1 and so on EN, we obtain these images if E1, if EN. And this element form the matrix of this linear transformation. This row matrix, which has one rows and n columns. The numbers of columns coincide with dimensions of the vector space V, and the number of the rows coincide with dimensions of the vector space K. But vector space K is a one-dimensional vector space, and we obtain one row, the matrix of this linear transformation. And this fact, it follows from previous reasoning with a corollary of above proved facts. We can, by parallel way, we can introduce the so-called dual basis in the dual vector space. What does mean dual basis? If you fixed the basis E in initial vector space V, we can consider the following set of the functionals in the dual space. Namely, let E with up indices I, the sum, the functionals which defined the following properties. If you apply these functionals to vectors, to vector of the initial basis, if you apply I's functionals to the vectors which has number j, we obtain unit if I inside j and zero if I not equal j. These properties is uniquely defined the functionals. The functionals is a linear map, and as any linear maps, as any linear map, uniquely defined by its values on the basic vectors. This condition is uniquely defined, this linear functional. And easy to see that these functionals form the basis in the dual vector space. We show that the dimension of the dual vector space equal n. And easy to see that these linear functionals are linear independent. And if we proved this linear functional linear independent, we prove that these linear functionals form the basis in the vector space, because the dimension is equal to n. And if you have n linearly independent vectors in n-dimensional vector space, these vectors form the basis, form a basis in this vector space. And let's prove that these functionals are linearly independent. Proposition. One en form a basis in dual vector space V star. Proof. Sufficiently to prove that U1 EN are linearly independent. We can prove this fact apply definition of the linearly independence. We can consider the linear combination of this functional and suppose that this linear combination is equal to zero. And our claim to prove that all coefficients this linear combination are equal to zero. And it means that these vectors are linearly independent. We can apply this functional to the basic vectors. Let's apply this linear combination to the basic vectors EJ. And we obtain that this linear combination is equal lambda I E up I, which apply EJ. The sum I goes from 1 to n. And by definition, the result application, the vectors EI to the E up I to the vectors EJ is equal 1 if I coincide J, and 0 if I is not equal J. We can introduce the new notation delta IJ, which by definition is equal 1 if I is equal J, and 0 if I is not equal J. And this element is equal delta IJ, and we obtain that this sum is equal lambda J. By definition, this value is equal 0, and we obtain that lambda J is equal 0 for all J. We can consider arbitrary number J, and in arbitrary case we obtain that all lambda J is equal 0. From this fact, it follows that all coefficients of this linear combination is equal 0. And it means that these vectors are linearly independent, and we have exactly n such vectors. And from this fact, it follows that these vectors form the basis in this vector space. And we obtain so-called some distinguished basis, which called dual basis. I repeat, if we fixed some basis in the initial vector space V, we can consider some fixed basis which called dual basis, which basis we consider in relation with initial basis. And this dual basis is defined by the following conditions: the values of the dual basis on the vectors of the initial basis is equal 1 if the number of the vector dual basis coincide with the number of the initial basis, and equal 0 if the numbers are not equal. And the following interesting fact, that if we consider the coordinates of the functional in the dual basis, the coordinates of the functional coincide with the element of the matrix of functional if we consider functional as a linear transformation. Proposition two. Let F be element of the dual vector space V star, and let Fi be the value of our functional on the vectors of the initial basis, and let E1 En is a basis of V, and we can fix the some numbers Fi, which equal the values of functional F on the basic vectors Ei, and Fe is a matrix of the our functional F. We can consider the decomposition of F in the terms of the dual basis. We proved that functional E up 1 E up n forms the dual basis in the dual vector space. And let's consider the decomposition of the R functional F into linear combination of the basic vectors EI in the dual vector space. And let's apply this functional to the basic vectors EJ. By definition, this values is equal FI. And if we apply if you apply the functional to the basic vector EJ, and if we use the property of linearity of the linear functional, by definition we obtain that this sum is equal alpha I EI, which we apply to the vector EJ, and this element is equal delta IJ, and we obtain alpha I delta IJ and is equal alpha alpha j, I'm sorry, alpha j. And from this equality it follows that fj is equal alpha j, and the decomposition of the arbitrary functional f in terms of the dual basis has the coordinates f I, which coincide with elements of the matrix of this linear functionals, if we understand these functionals as a linear transformation, as a linear transformation. And this we obtain the following assertion. We can consider the linear functional as a linear transformation, and we can consider the linear functional as element of the dual vector space. And we can consider the matrix of this linear transformation and coordinates of the functional in the dual base. In both cases, we obtain the same matrices. In the first case, we obtain the matrix of the linear transformation, and this matrix is a row matrix. And the second case, we obtain the coordinates of this functional, which we understand as a vector in the dual space. And the coordinates of these vectors form the sum rows, which coincide with matrix rows of the matrix which we understand as a linear transformation. And we obtain that these two different type of description of linear functional are coincide. And we can rewrite the action of linear functional on the vector of the vector space in terms of the coordinates of these vectors. Let f be the linear functionals, and we have decomposition of these linear functionals in the terms of the dual basis. And let v be the vector, and we also decompose these vectors in the terms of the initial basis E I. And let's apply our functional to the our vector V. And we obtain the following sequences of the equalities. We can use linearity property, and we obtain the last equality is equal but the if you apply the vector the functional of the dual basis to the vector of the initial basis, we obtain delta ij. And we obtain that this equality is equal fi vi. And we can rewrite this equality in the matrix form as a result of application of the matrix row of our linear functional, which we understand as a linear transformation, and the coordinate of the vector v in the initial basis v. And this calculation can explain us how we can describe the linear functional and the vectors in the space Rn. We can present the element of the vector space Rn as a vector column and maybe Kn. You can consider the arbitrary field K in this case. And the dual space Kn star naturally isomorphic Kn. But the elements of the dual vector space naturally present as a vector rows. we have some canonical presentation. We can present the element, the elements of the initial vector space Kn as a vector column, and the elements of the dual vector space Kn dual as a vector rows. And we have naturally defined action of the element of the dual space on the element of the initial vector space. And this action we can present as a product, matrix product of the rows and column. If we apply functional F to the vector V, this action we can present as a present of the vector row, which present the coordinates of the functional V in the dual basis, and the vector column, which form the coordinates of the vector V in the initial basis V. Maybe now naturally consider some example of the vector space and its dual. First of all, we can consider we have one example. This reasoning we can consider as the example of the vector space and its dual. Example one, Kn and Kn dual. The element Kn we can consider as vector columns. T denote the transposition operation, and Kn dual we can present do you understand this fact? Maybe any question about? And the main fact, which was proved, that elements of the vector space Kn we can consider as a matrix column, and the elements of the dual vector space we can consider as a vector row. And the action of the functional on the vector we can present as a product of the vector row and the vector column. Do you understand that? No? Yes, understand. Okay. If you understand this example, we can consider many less trivial example. Let V be the space of polynomial. This element on the with coefficients in the basic field K. The element of this vector space, the expressions in the following form. The elements of this vector space are polynomials. We can to add a polynomial, and we can multiply the polynomial onto element of the basic field K on the scalar. And we have two operations, addition and scalar multiplication on the space of polynomial. And we obtain that the polynomial form the vector space. And we can consider the following functionals, which we can denote by FR. And if we apply this functional to the element PT, PT is some polynomial A0, A1T, and so on, AKT. Tk, t degree k. And the result of the application such functional is equal to the value of this functional in the point R. R is equal 1, 2, 3, and so on. And we obtain essentially many linear functionals, which acts on this infinite dimensional vector space. And example 3 may be enough simple example, but example 3. Let's consider the finite dimensional vector space. Let V be R. R is a real number field. Then low index 2 denoted that we consider the polynomial of degree less or equal to the element of this vector space are polynomial in the following form: a0, a1t, a2t square. The coefficients are real numbers, and we can consider some fixed basis in this vector space. Let E the following basis: 1, t, t square divided 2. The first base vectors E1 is equal 1, E2 is equal t. E3 is equal t square, the ratio t square 2. We have the following fixed basis. But what does mean the dual basis in this case? Let's consider the dual basis. How to describe the dual basis? The first vector of the dual basis E up 1 uniquely defines the following condition: E1 maps E up 1 into 1, E up 2 maps into 0, E3 maps into 0. We have the following condition is defined the first basic vectors. The question: can we express this functional E up E up one in terms of the functional of such case as a functional which defined by as evaluation functional. This functional we can consider as evaluation functional because if you apply such functional, the result is calculation of the value of the functions in the some fixed point. And the example of this so-called evaluation functional. This functional is defined by the following condition. If you apply this functional to the first basic vectors, we apply unit. In the other cases, we obtain zero. Can we express this functional in terms of the functionals of such type as evaluation functional? Easy to see, this value is equal 1 and this is equal 0. Easy to see that this functional E1, if we apply this functional to any polynomial P, is equal E1. E1 we can consider F, the functional F1, as an evaluation functional. Do you understand this fact? No? Yes? Mm-hmm. This functional we can consider as evaluation. The question, can we describe in the similar terms the second basic vector of the dual basis E1? E up to. Can we consider in the similar terms the second basic functional E2? E2 maps E1 into 0, E2 maps 1, E3 maps into 0. Can we describe in the same terms this functional? Yes, we can, first of all, we can apply operation differentiation of the functional. And after them, we can apply evaluation and we can consider the value of this functional in the point t is equal 0. Easy to see. If you apply this functional to the t, we differentiate this this polynomial t, and after them we consider the value of this element in the point t is equal 0, and we obtain unit. If we apply this functional to the one, we obtain 0. If you obtain to the t square, after differentiation, we obtain 2t, and in the point t is equal 0, we obtain 0. And by the same way, we can obtain the third basic vector of this dual space the same way. So basic vectors is equal E1 if we apply this third vector to the any polynomial, we obtain after a simple calculation, we must consider the second derivative of this expression. We obtain A2, and the value in the arbitrary and the value of this element on the arbitrary polynomial is equal to the highest coefficients in this polynomial. If we consider the partial case when A0, A1 are equal to 0 and A2 is equal to 1, we obtain that if we apply this polynomial we obtain a unit. And so we obtain that these functionals form the dual basis, namely E1 is equal F0 E2 is a combination functional F0 and functional differentiation. Namely, we present this vector of the dual basis as a linear combination of some linear transformation differentiation, and functional of evaluation functional. And we present the vectors of the dual basis, but we can apply coordinate isomorphism to this vector space, and using this coordinate isomorphism we can present the element of the dual basis in the coordinate form, in the coordinates form. And in this case we can obtain more simple description of the vectors of the dual basis. Okay, and the following assertion Uh, the following construction, the so-called annihilator. What does mean annihilator? We suppose that V is a vector space. We will suppose that V is a finite dimensional vector space. Dimension V is equal n. And let U be some subspace of this vector space. U vector subspace. Vector subspace. And let's introduce the new notion, annihilator of the vector space U. Annihilator is a set of functionals, the element of the dual vector space alpha, such that alpha U is equal to zero for any U from vector subspace U. The annihilator U is all functionals which maps the vector space U into zero vector. Into zero vector. All functionals which maps U into zero vectors. We can present the annihilator as a set of such functionals such that any functionals contain the subspace U into its kernel. Into its kernel. Theorem, the main theorem, asserts that the dimension theorem, dimension of annihilator is equal n minus dimension dimension U. We can n is equal dimension V. Other words, the dimension of annihilator is equal to the difference between dimension V and dimension U. Proof. Proof of this result. Let's choose. Basis E1, EK of U. Let's choose the sum basis in the vector subspace U and extend this basis to the basis of V. basis V. I said, if you consider dual basis in V star, let V1, Vk, Vk plus 1, and be the let be the dual basis of V star dual to the initial basis E. Let's prove that the linear span of the vector coincide with annihilator. Let's prove this fact. How to prove that the linear span of the last vectors E up k plus 1 and so on, E up n coincide with annihilator of the subspace U0. How to prove this fact? Obviously for you that any this functional belongs U0. First of all, let's prove this inclusion. Let's prove this fact. If you consider E1 and let's consider, oh, I'm sorry. E k plus 1 and so on. E up n, the linear span of these vectors belongs to the U0. Let's consider first of these vectors, E k plus 1, and apply these vectors to the basic vectors E I. And we obtain zero if I is equal 1, 2, and so on k. The same way, if you apply the second vector E k plus 2 to the any from the first k vectors, we obtain also 0. And so on. It means that any vectors of from this linear span belongs to the annihilator. Because if the vectors of the generative system belongs to the subspace, that it follows that any linear combination of these vectors also belongs to the subspace. And it means that linear span of these vectors also belongs to the subspace. And we obtain inclusion of the linear span into annihilator of the vector space U. And let's prove the inclusion of the annihilator to this vector space. Let's consider the also functional from U0. It means that this arbitrary functional, we can let f be the arbitrary functional which belongs U0. Any functional we can decompose and present as a linear combination of the basic vectors of the dual vector space. I can present f as a linear combination of the vector of the dual basis. And I can apply this functional to them. Any basic vectors of the initial vector space U. I apply to the vectors EI, where I is equal 1, and so on, and K. And as a result of, IJ. And as a result, such application we obtain Fi. But our functional F belongs to the annihilator, and it means that the result of such application is equal to 0. And we obtain that Fi is equal zero. Fj is equal zero for j, 1, and so on, k. And from this fact, it follows that this decomposition has the following form: Fi ei I goes from k plus 1 to n. And it means that any functional from the annihilator can be present as a linear combination of these vectors of the dual basis. And it means that the dimension of the annihilator is equal n minus k. Dimension is equal n, this is equal k, dimension n minus k. And the theorem is proved. Any question? This, in my opinion, non-trivial fact is to use the dual basis. I'm not sure that is enough non-trivial fact, but the general approach to the study of the dual space to use the dual basis in any cases. And in this case, we choose the sum basis in the initial vector space. After that, we extend this basis to the basis in the all vector space, and we consider the dual basis. And the main idea, the vectors of the dual basis ek1 en form the basis in the annihilator, is the main observation, how to calculate the annihilator? We can consider some simple example to find annihilator in the some simple case. I suggest the following. Example. Let V and let U be the linear span of the vector 1 plus P. Find annihilator U0 solution. First of all, let's consider the coordinate isomorphism phi. Let E is equal 1 t, the ratio t square 2, that's the basis, and we can correspond any vectors, any functional, oh I'm sorry, we consider the any element, any polynomial in the coordinates of this polynomial in the basis be the following element a0, a1, 2, i2. This isomorphism transform this polynomial in this coordinate vectors. And in this basis, the U generated the following vectors 1, 1, 0. 1, 1, 0. And the problem is to find the element in the dual space which annihilate these vectors. We can present the element of the dual vector space V star as a vector rows. And if you apply the functional to the vector, we consider the functional as a vector row and the vector as a vector column, and let if let's denote this vector by U, and if I apply the functional x to the vector U, I obtain the product of the vector row and the vector column, and I obtain the following equality, and the result must be equal zero, and I obtain the linear system, the system of the linear equation, the linear system. and my claim to find the basis in the space of solution of this linear system. And this basis form this basis in the annihilator. And I obtain that x1 is equal minus x2, and I can try to find the basis. I have that the dimension of the all vector space is equal 3, and the dimension of the U is equal 1. And using above proved theorem, I obtain that the dimension of the annihilator is equal 3 minus 1 and is equal 2. And I must obtain two basic vectors. I can put x2 is equal 1 and x3 is equal 0. And I obtain that x1 is equal 1. And also I can put x2 is equal 0, x3 is equal 1, and I obtain x1 is equal 1. And I obtain that the u 0 annihilator of the u is a linear span of these two vectors, minus 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. And I can rewrite these vectors in the term of the initial functional. I call that the first functional correspond to the functional f0. This functional correspond f0 differentiation, and this functional correspond composition differentiation and d2. And I obtain the following the following linear span, which for which equal the annihilator, namely minus f0 plus f0 d, and f0 d. This linear functional form the generating system in the annihilator, in the initial vector space. And I can rewrite in this I recall that I denoted f0 the functional which if we apply this functional to the any polynomial p, we obtain the value of this polynomial is in the point zero. And f0 d, if we apply to the functional p, we obtain p prime in point of zero. And the f0 d square is equal any question about this example? Do you understand this? In my opinion, enough complex example. In this case, we calculate the annihilator. The calculation can be divided on two steps. First step, we transform our vector space into vector space R3. We choose the same basis in this vector space, and pass to the arithmetical vectors, the coordinate vectors. This. This correspondence is defined the change of the initial vector space of the polynomial onto vector space Ri. After them, we calculate the annihilator as a solution of the linear system, because application of the functional to the vector we can consider as a matrix product of the vector row and the vector column. And if we consider linear functional at the vector row, and if we apply this functional to this fixed vector, we obtain the sum linear equation. This variable, which are coordinates of the functional of the element of the dual space. We solve this linear equation and obtain the basis in the dual vector space. And the vector of the dual basis form the basis in the annihilator. And we can write the annihilator as a linear span of this basic vector. And the last step, we pass from this coordinate presentation to the element of the initial vector, dual vector space. We know that the first basic vector of the dual vector space corresponds to the sum fixed functional f0. The second vector corresponds to the linear functionals, which composition of differentiation evaluation functional. And second composition, second order differentiation and the evaluation functional in the point of zero. And we rewrite this coordinate form in the form of this element. Three steps. First, change of the initial vector space by space Rn. Step two, standard calculation. We solve the linear system. And third step, inverse. Inverse mapping from the vector space Rn to the initial dual vector space. And for this change, we use a description of the vector of the dual basis in the terms of the function. And the maybe most non-trivial step. Okay. And the last item of our lecture, so-called second dual space. What does mean second dual space? Second dual space. We consider the following trick. We can consider the dual space as a basic space, and we can consider the dual space to the dual space. This dual space is called second dual space. We can consider the functionals which we apply to the functionals. Easy to see. We can consider let's fix some let V be the vector of the initial vector space. If F be functional, the element of the dual vector space. If we apply the functional to the vector, we obtain the sum numbers. But let's consider the following state. I suggest to fix vector V and consider arbitrary functional F. And this expression we can consider as a result application some functional of the second dual space to the functional F. Let's introduce the element of the dual second space V, which we will denote by F V. I'm sorry, let's change notation. Let's be alpha V. We will consider the result application of the element of the second dual space to the functional alpha as a result application of functional alpha to the vector V. And we obtain the following natural inclusion. V we can consider as a subset of V to start. In other words, we can consider the elements of initial vector space as the element of the second dual space. And the main theorem asserts that this two vector space dual second dual vector space and initial vector space are coincide. The main theorem is amazing fact. Theorem. We have the following natural isomorphism: second dual space and initial vector space V. Excuse me, I have no time, and I'm going to prove this theorem at the next lecture. But maybe just 1 minute. I try to explain the main idea. We obtain inclusion of the vector space V into dual vector space V star. And the main idea is that the dimension of the image in this vector space coincide with dimension of this vector space V star. And enough easier to check this fact. If V finite dimensional, we proved above that the dimension of dual vector space coincides with the dimension of the vector space. And the main idea that this inclusion is injective. If the dimension of this vector space V is equal n, and the dimension of this vector space is equal n, and if we proved this inclusion is injective, we proved this isomorphism. That's enough easier. Easy to check that kernel of this inclusion is zero. And let's prove this theory. And in detail, I explain this proof on the next lecture.